just wrote a poem the other day entitled Truth. It says, the face of truth is open, the eyes of truth are bright, the lips of truth are ever closed, the head of truth is upright, the breast of truth stands forward, the gaze of truth is straight. Truth has neither fear nor doubt, truth has patience to wait. The words of truth are touching, the voice of truth is deep, the law of truth is simple, all you sow you reap.
I had written several plays and nothing was happening. I had a bit part in a film, and then finally I was really spiraling downward fast, and I wanted to write something about the way I felt, but I knew my story wasn't commercial, wasn't translatable in many languages. And then, as fate would have it, I went to a boxing match that night, and I saw Muhammad Ali and Chuck Webner. Something just popped. I said, that's it. That's me.
His name is Rocky. His whole life was a million to one shot.
The Bayonne Bleeder, Chuck Webner. I said, that is the way I feel.
On the right of me, the Raging Bull, Bob De Niro, and on the left of me, Rocky, Sylvester Stallone. I stayed on the set while he finished that scene, and then I said I had to go. But, you know, I felt bad. And I finally said to myself, I'm a real jerk. This guy's been using my name for 30 years to promote the Rocky franchise. 30 years of bullshit. I'm sick and tired of this guy, and I went out and got myself a lawyer, and I decided to sue him.
How do you think the city of Philadelphia has treated Joe Frazier?
Well, there's a statue of Rocky near the Art Museum, but nowhere in the entire city is there a statue of Joe.
Right next to the steps that Joe Frazier, Sylvester Stallone ran up, you know, for the Rocky movie. That's where they have the statue of Rocky Balboa. Instead of one of Joe Frazier.
And did you used to run up the steps of
That's right, yeah. I mean, yeah, sometimes I walk, you know, up and down because, you know, this is how I run back down, up. And then you run back down, but you have no energy to stop yourself from running when you're coming downhill.
And the door opens, and in walks Ali. And he says to me, Chuck, when we go out on stage with Douglas, he says, I want you to call me a nigger. And I said, geez, champ, I said, I can't do that. I said, I have a lot of black friends. I said, some of my sparring partners are black. He's, no, you got to do this. You got to use the N-word. You got to call me a nigger. He says, we got to pump this fight up, and we're going to make it look like a racial thing.
That has been made the greatest has been painted and colored white. So, like Jesus is white, you have Santa Claus white, Tarzan, King of the Jungles, he's white, Miss America's white, Miss Universe is white, Miss World is white. When you go to heaven, you walk on a milky white way. Before you go to heaven, everything seems to be white. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Angel hair is white. Angel food cake is white. And devil food cake is dark. And Mary had a little lamb. His feet is white as snow. So everything, the greatest so far, has been white. And these are just false.
Ali's sharp tongue always gave him an edge in the pre-bout banter. But when he called Frazier an Uncle Tom, a black man who is subservient to whites, he went too far.
Ali had an element of cruelty to him. There's been a bid to sanitize Ali. The movie, the Will Smith movie, Ali certainly did that. To make him almost this kind of demigod. And Ali could be a cruel bastard. Ali?
Toledo, you really pick on big guys, you know that?
He's a white fella. He don't like colored people.
He calls you by your old name, too?
No, he called me by another name. You didn't hear him last week.
He started saying, he did this, he did that. I was getting all nervous because, I couldn't stop the guy.
He called me. Oh, this could be a real
experience now, professional. Jaw's been broke, been lost. knocked down a couple times. Bad. Been chopping trees. I done something new for this fight. I done wrestled with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
Bad dude.
Counter flash, that's 400 a second. Now, the minute I hit silent listen, all of those people blink to that moment. That's why you
told him I don't have nothing but a prayer. Well, chump all I
I don't want no excuses about Tuck. Not one shot.
He's a master of the poem, so I wrote a poem that goes like this. What's in a word? And who's to say what will be? I know he'll be the favorite, but that's as it should be. For there are those who say that he's the best to ever wear the crown. And that this fight's a tune-up against someone of little renown.
First round knockout, one punch and then first round knockout, and he was out until a count of 10.
That man, let me tell you, he can't write no poems, he can't predict no rounds, and let me tell you, I'm not conceited, I'm just convinced. Harry, listen, I'm so modest, I can admit my own fault. And my only fault is, I don't realize how great I really am.
Sweeping hook.
That was a double shot.
Okay, tell me about that.
It was a body shot and then repeat up top.
Well, you saw him go down on his back. His feet were up. His tassels were flying on a shoot. Did you think, uh-oh, this is it. I got him knocked out.
We both were dead. No, that's just probably the act of God.
My big knife, and lo and behold, who shows up and steals everybody's thunder but Muhammad Ali?
Muhammad!
And as soon as he walked in, all the press left me, left Sonny, left everybody, and ran over to the champ.
Identify with the blue collar hard worker, you know, the life story, the guy who struggled. It's Joe Frazier.
Didn't I tell you your hands can't hear what your eyes can't see? You know I'm the greatest of all times. I'm telling this when we get in clinches. And where is a man to beat him and talk to him? You understand?
Do they talk back to you?
No. Only one fellow talked back to me, and that's Joe Frazier. I hit Joe Frazier with about 90 punches, if you remember the first fight. I hit him with everything. The man took a terrible beating. He wouldn't fall. I said, are you crazy? I hit him there. I said, you must be crazy. He said, that's right. I'm crazy. Just kept him. I'm crazy.
Then in 1996, Ali lit the flame at the Atlanta Olympics. Most of the world looked on in awe.
He was a hero.
The only dissenting voice being that of Joe Frazier, who said Ali should have fallen into the flame. The rest of us thought it was wonderful. And yet the rest of us knew what Joe was talking about.
We was fighting. We was at war. I mean, why should he speak all this terrible thing about me? And then I didn't say anything about him. So whatever came to my mind and my lips, I spit it out. And that's the way it is. But I didn't really hope anything happened to the guy. You know, I wish he lived a whole long life like all the other guys.
See, I wrote a poem. He said, Joe, come out smoking. I'll be poking, pouring water on that smoking. He said, I might have made you. I was a pile of smoking Joe Frazier.
Almost
a great guy. I would say we love him. He's a fine champion.
Oh, Lord.
Thank you.
Hey, how you doing, Mick? This thing's falling apart, boy.
The whole world's falling apart. Look at us.
Don't talk crazy, Paulie. You know, I think if you live someplace long enough, you are that place.
I ain't no talking building. Come on, it's getting late, Rocco. I get a headache from this train.
I see you put your dollars tucked into your socks.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you look, huh? Dollars, huh?
That's a lot of love.
It is. I work for it. Very hard to, personally.
Were you working for it at the minute?
I work for it very hard.
Well, that was great. Thank you for that.
Can I go?
Yeah, we're just...